Coming up on ATETV. Engineering.
I really wouldn't go any more than a tenth of a mile. Look at the speeds we're going at.
GPS and GIS.
I just press the button, see the steering wheel take over. I'm driving hands-free across on my AB line right now.
And rapid manufacturing.
What we end up with after we're done, we're getting a full three-dimensional model.
Now on ATETV. From across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. If you've ever thought about changing careers or considered going back to school to catch up on new technology, our next segment proves that it's never too late.
You talk about the altitude?
All I want is in between the two charges.
That everything counterclockwise is positive, and everything clockwise is negative.
Don't need to be too close to the turning point.
Which one we try first?
No, that's that one. We had to draw a circle around it.
Came back and did it. The school that I attend is Florence-Darlington Technical College, and I'm in the Electronic Engineering Technology program.
Yeah. This
is still wet?
I think so.
My advice to an older person who may be considering coming back to school is that it's never too late. It is a sacrifice that you have to make to come back. A lot of things you have to put on hold. But there is time to achieve something like this. So I graduated from high school. I went on to attend South Carolina State University and majored in accounting and marketing, minor in economics. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to finish that degree. And I ended up working for years and eventually decided to come back to school.
Reading from the bottom?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Once I came out here and started meeting some of the staff, and they were very warm and welcoming, and it just kind of sucked me right on in.
PowerPoint, somebody else is going to have to step up and do that person's part.
I really wouldn't go any more than a tenth of a mile. Look at the speeds we're going at.
Start from here, and somebody got to be on that side.
I decided to come into the electronic engineering field. I felt that I was behind in a lot of things technology-wise. And so in order to enhance my horizon in the technology field, I thought that this would be a good avenue for me to come in and try to learn a lot of the technical aspects of things that were going on nowadays.
Now all I want is in between the two charges, okay?
Competition in the jobs is very high. And I need that extra effort in my classes. I put forth a lot of extra effort to try to make certain that when it comes time to go out into the work field and interview or trying to seek that job, that I have something extra to carry along with me to try to make things work out in my favor. After graduation, my plans are to utilize the school as far as job placement is concerned and hopefully to start a career in the engineering technology field, hopefully with an energy company in this area, DuPont. We have several companies in this area that do work in that field. It was something new, something fresh, something that I hadn't done before, and I just wanted to come in. I wanted something that would challenge me.
Najee is really motivated to make it in the field of electrical engineering. He already has plans to give back to the community and be a role model for his family. As new technologies like GPS and GIS are applied to the agricultural industry, there is a growing need for skilled technicians who have both mechanical and computer skills.
Kirkwood, within this agriculture GPS GIS program, provides a lot of different skills for our students. And some of those include computer skills, and some of those are mechanical skills.
Pushing goes on first, and then this air clutch goes next to it, and then you have this clamp. Okay, that's the order that it goes on.
I think what we can provide is that diverse set of skills for the students to be able to gain employment in a wide range of occupations.
The best class that I've taken here so far would be Precision Ag Hardware. It's more hands-on, you learn a lot, you put things on. We got great dealerships that work with us and give us the equipment to put on our tractors and planters here.
The software classes were probably the most important part of it. Without that software and knowing how to use that software, all the data you collect in the field is probably useless.
Agriculture technology is the use of new technologies applied to the agriculture industry. I think a lot of people will recognize GPS. We can use that same system in a tractor in order to guide it through the field and help plant.
I just press a button, see the steering wheel take over. I'm driving hands-free across on my AB line right now.
It also refers to geographic information systems. That same system is used to analyze data from the field and help farmers make a better decision.
As farming operations get larger and it becomes more expensive to farm that acre of ground, and more guys move toward the technology side of things to help offset those costs a little bit, there'll be a large opportunity for guys with technology skills or degrees in technology that can help those guys get to where they want to be.
For many years, precision agriculture kind of plateaued and farmers didn't really see the economic value of this technology. With this newest technology, the guidance systems, the seed control, the swath control type of technology, there's a lot of farmers excited, and it seems like we cannot graduate enough students to meet the demand.
High-tech agriculture companies that implement new technology and computer software can only succeed if they hire highly skilled technicians. Your local community college can help you get the education you need to become a part of this growing field. Now we're going off-road to Saddleback College, where three-dimensional models printed by computers are helping students change the pace of design and manufacturing.
I'm gonna pass this around and pull your project out, set it down in front of you, and then we'll go over that.
Rapid manufacturing is taking a three-dimensional model and being able to produce it in less than a week. We got our model that we could see in the CAD.
Okay, open the door.
We'll set up the machine and it'll literally print that physical model. It's like basically sending it to your home printer. So what we end up with after we're done, we're getting a full three-dimensional model. But some of these parts can actually be functionally used. Kawasaki Racing came to me because rapid prototyping actually hasn't hit the racing market yet. For their off-road racing, they don't use the headlight during the day. So what they wanted to do was replace the headlight with a vent. So what we went ahead and did is we reverse engineered the headlight by laser scanning it. And then we went ahead and built a final part, which has vent holes through it and vent lines on the bottom, and that is our final product. For the medical industry, our basis is pretty much just taking MRIs that doctors will give us, and we'll go ahead and print those actual models, give it to the doctor. So now he's got something on the table that he could actually physically look at. For us students, we're actually working in the field. But we're also learning at the same time. So it's kind of like an internship, but we're getting paid for it. I basically want to focus on the military side, either go to Boeing or work for the Navy, I'm not really sure yet. I've always dreamed of being able to design my part. Yeah, I got it on the computer, wow. I want to actually physically have it, you know, I want to see what it looks like. So now I'm actually able to prototype something. It may not be the actual material that I want, but I have a physical model now.
Community colleges like Saddleback are giving students the education and opportunities to start their careers and begin designing the future in record time. For more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at atetv.org. Thanks for watching.